As of now, 800 ships have sunk in the Drake Passage. Those are just the ones we know about. Around 20,000 people have died, and they keep dying to this day. This is about a place where anything can randomly happen. Today, many ships that want to get from the Atlantic to the Pacific use the Panama Canal. Yes, it's faster, much safer, and cheaper, with less fuel consumption and operating costs for shipping companies. However, only 37% of global ocean shipping can pass through the Panama Canal. The rest of the megaships simply can't squeeze through it, and therefore have to sail around Cape Horn and face the Drake Passage, and come out of that encounter unscathed. In 1819, the Spanish vessel San Telmo sank while transporting reinforcements to Peru during the War for Independence, and all 644 people tragically died at sea. And recently, in 2022, a rogue wave crashed into a cruise ship traveling from Antarctica to Argentina. This frightening event killed one person and injured four others. A massive wall of water slammed into the ship, throwing passengers around and shattering several outer windows. Some rooms were flooded, while others had their walls knocked down. But what is the reason behind the sinking of ships in the Drake Passage? The average ship takes about 48 hours to get from one end of the Drake Passage to the other. However, sailors who've managed to get through the passage say they remember those 48 hours for the rest of their lives. People on cruises say you can't even eat without constantly holding onto your plate and glass. The strong waves make the dishes slide around the table, and they use special sticky mats, but they don't always work. To eat, you need something like 8 hands. Not to mention you also need to hold onto the chair and table because they slide too. Naturally, due to the strong rocking, people often feel ill. So on the ship, there are definitely barf bags attached somewhere in the common areas. But actually everything on the tables, including the laptops, has to be secured. And not just on the tables alone. Things should be tied down, and loose items should be stored in drawers. Otherwise, they might very well fly into your head during the next wave. You can only move around the ship by grabbing onto railings or poles for support. Going up and down the stairs, or even just opening and closing doors, requires a lot of effort to avoid getting hurt. You have also to tie yourself to your bed, so you can sleep while crossing the passage. The thing is, the ship interacts with the waves differently. The only thing that helps is tying yourself down. So, what's this place? And why is the sea here so wild? Drake Passage stretches between Cape Horn at the southern tip of South America and Livingston Island in the South Shetland Islands. In simple terms, it's the gap between Antarctica and South America. There are two other passages around the southern tip of South America, the Strait of Magellan and the Beagle Channel, but they wind around, often narrowing and leaving little room for maneuvering. Unpredictable winds and tidal currents make these straits almost impossible to navigate. So, most sailing ships prefer the Drake Passage, which offers open water for hundreds of miles. But not all ships can make it through, as there's no specific storm season there, and it can happen at any time of the year. It's all because of the location. The Drake Passage is narrow, and is the point where the three largest oceans in the world meet: the Pacific, the Atlantic, and the Southern Oceans. Naturally, cyclones here are just insane. Cold water from Antarctica meets relatively warm ocean water, and suddenly a cyclone appears. The region, stretching over an area of about 620 miles, constantly generates very dangerous storms. But in addition to the temperature difference in the water, the absence of land also plays a part. The Southern Ocean, which surrounds the icy continent of Antarctica, has no land masses, so the winds can easily wrap around the continent. But in the Northern Hemisphere, similar winds are completely separated by vast land masses, so they can't really pick up speed. In the Drake Passage, the wind blows at speeds of 30 to 45 miles per hour. Some of the biggest waves in the Drake Passage reach heights of 66 feet. These waves hit any ship in the strait one after another. So do you have the courage to be on board one of the ships facing those waves? Let me know your thoughts below in the comments. I think it's time now to subscribe to the channel if you haven't subscribed yet. And as usual, you owe me a like. See you very soon with a new episode.